As we have observed the impact of the pandemic on the way people work, we've seen a massive shift of people working from home and also working in hybrid work situations. And as we observe this, we've been able to use digital telemetry to actually measure an organization's health by looking at the network collaboration patterns between individuals. Now, I should note that when we do this, we always do this in a way that is an aggregate, and we do this in a way that's privacy preserving. My name is Jonathan Larson, and I'm a data scientist and a network machine learning expert at Microsoft Research. I lead a couple projects on societal resilience, and today I'm excited to tell you about our latest research on how we use network machine learning and apply it to organizational science, which then ultimately can help better inform how society at large can also be resilient. Let me introduce you to a few new metrics that we've developed specifically to better help understand organizational health and analytics. The first metric I'm going to introduce you to here today is called freedom. Freedom is a metric that lets us understand and compare the formal organizational hierarchy as derived from human resources and compare that to the actual observed hierarchies and work groups that are observed from the informal communication structures of people just working. So to give you a quick example, if you have a group that has very, very high freedom, that is a group that is probably working across the company. So you might have an engineering group that's working with marketing, sales, finance. That group would probably have a lot of freedom because those people are working with other people that are not necessarily in their hierarchy. On the contrary, if a group has very low freedom, that means that they're really only working within the confines of that HR-defined organization, and they're not really collaborating with people outside of that group that is very close to them there. The next metric I'd like to introduce you to here today is called fluidity. Now, fluidity is called omni, if you take a look at the graspable logic library that is backing this. But what fluidity helps you measure is how much a person's network changes over time. So for example, if you have a developer that's working inside of a core team that's not experiencing much change month over month, and they're just talking to the same people at the same volume every month, they would have a very low fluidity score. If you have someone, for example, who is reorged into a completely different organization, and now they're talking to completely new people, that person would have a very, very high fluidity. And so this allows us to actually measure this change over time based on the network collaboration patterns that are observed. So with these metrics, we've been looking at how has COVID actually impacted the way people work? How have their organizational networks changed? So for that, let me show you this image here that actually shows a definitive change that we actually observed across COVID. This is looking at about 4,000 different organizations and looking at the siloing score behavior, which is actually a function of a company's modularity, and looking at the modularity before COVID and after COVID. And what we see is that once companies shift to a work from home posture, they invariably shift to a much more siloed posture, as you can see here on this chart. And so there's a very noticeable statistical effect that we can observe from the effects of COVID. So now that we've seen how COVID has affected these network analytics and these measures of organizational health, let's put it into practice and show you how we've actually deployed these capabilities into product. In this next demonstration here, I'm going to show you Viva Insights, the Azure Templates Organizational Network Analytics feature. In this tool here, we've loaded up a fake company where all the nodes in here are completely fake and there's no personal information in here. And we're going to look at some of these network metrics to analyze the health of this company. So for this company, the first metric we're going to look at is called workgroup stability. This helps us understand the workgroups and how much those workgroups change over time. So if you have a high stability, that can be good, but if it's too stable, that might also give you indication that you might want to have those groups collaborating more with others. Now we can also click on this, and when we click on it, it'll actually color each of the nodes by their fluidity, which gives you another sense of stability. So you can get a sense for understanding how much each of those nodes are changing over time in their network communication patterns. The next tab that we're going to look at here is called network silo behavior. And what this measures is the modularity and the siloing nature of each of these groups. So when I select this, it will start showing you which groups are perhaps at risk of breaking away and becoming too siloed. And you might want to get them connected up with other groups to help remediate that. The last metric we have is called employee cohesion. And this metric helps you understand within a two-hop neighborhood, what's the connectivity that we're observing. So for example, if I'm talking to Jim and I'm talking to Marcia, what are the chances that Jim and Marcia are also connected? If they're connected, that leads to a higher employee cohesion. And if they're not, that leads to a lower employee cohesion. Now that I've shown you how we can use these metrics to better understand organizational analytics, let's turn our attention to how we can use these analytics to actually understand what's going on in the world. And for that, I'm going to use a snapshot of a chart that we had built for the Work Trends Index for the 2021 release. And in this, we can actually again see that siloing behavior across thousands of organizations as it skyrockets as COVID strikes and then starts to wane, but never quite returns to the pre-pandemic normal. We hope that you've enjoyed this content on organizational analytics and resilience, and thank you for watching.